All right, it might not look like it, but I'm actually doing some magic right now. Okay, I'm not the one doing the magic. I don't have any card tricks. There's nothing under my hat. I'm not wearing a hat. Note to self, get some hats. No, I'm talking about charging my phone wirelessly, actually. And not just my phone, but all the phones in the house. Mine, my wife's, my daughter's. And the real magic here, I think that it's actually kind of made me a little bit less of a slob. It might actually have me sleeping a little better at night. So this is the second of three videos that I'm doing sponsored by the Wireless Power Consortium, and that's still a really cool company name. So in the first video, we took a look at the very basics of wireless charging, what you need, why you might want to do it, and if you haven't watched that already, take a second, go do it, I'll wait. All right, you're back, good. So in this one, let's go take a look at how I'm using it and how my family is using it alongside me. Let's go. So okay, basics. You're gonna need a phone that has wireless charging or a case that goes on that phone that has wireless charging. Remember, we're talking about the Qi standard here, that's spelled QI. So for phones, all of Samsung's stuff from the past few years supports it. A couple generations of LG's phones now, the brand new iPhone 8, and yes, the iPhone X. Excuse me, iPhone 10. Whatever, very cool. So you'll also need a wireless charger, and yes, I get it. It's not completely wireless. You have to plug it into the wall. So if you're headed into the comments already, stop. We get it. So remember the key here, look for the logo on the box or on the charger itself to make sure that it's Qi certified. So you've got a phone that charges wirelessly. You've got a wireless charger that charges the phone wirelessly. You plug it in, you put the phone on it, you don't touch it, you just leave it alone, let it charge. That's it, super easy. So let's go take a look at what I'm using, and I'm gonna have links down below in the description if you wanna pick any of these up yourself. So I've actually got a few chargers stashed in various places all over the house. By my computer, I have one of those really good Samsung 2-amp chargers. It's not expensive, it's not brand new, but it just works really, really well. In the kitchen, I've got this Spigen charger so I can keep things charged up just while I'm cooking. I do kind of love the angle of it here so that I can keep a recipe or a video or whatever up on the screen while I'm cooking and still keep charging at the same time. Now my kid's kind of been doing the same thing with one of Samsung's chargers. It looks like a pillow. It does fast charging if it's supported on the phone, and it just looks nice, but really she can just prop it up and watch videos and stuff while she's charging too. Oh, and she needs to go clean her room. Now my wife's iPhone 6S doesn't do wireless charging out of the box, but she has a Mophie wireless charging case on it with extra battery, right? Now that comes along with a charging pad itself, and she's kept it on her nightstand and can just charge wirelessly that way. Super easy. But I tell you, I've actually kind of talked her out of using that, and here's why. So this is a triple charger from Ikea, and it's actually the only thing in this house from Ikea that didn't take me all day to put together. So I like this because first, it doesn't kind of look like your normal nerdy wireless charger, right? It fits in. Second, it does three phones at one time. So I can charge mine, my wife can charge hers, and my daughter can charge hers all out here in one place overnight, out of our bedrooms, away from our faces while we're sleeping. And you'd be surprised how much better you sleep when you know your phone just isn't right there waiting to go off at any time. So look, there's no right charger for anybody, right? There are a whole bunch out there. There are gonna be a whole bunch more out there. A couple things to keep in mind, just look for the Qi logo. That'll keep you out of trouble. You can worry about amperages and fast charging speeds and all that if you want. Me, I kind of care more about how it looks and where I'm gonna put it in the house. So if you have a cool wireless charger that you're using, let me know down in the comments. Maybe I'll pick one up. Stay tuned for the next video. We're gonna go for a little drive. It's gonna be fun. All right, that's it. Thanks again to the Wireless Power Consortium for putting us up to this. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and we'll catch you next time. See ya.